Okay, Nate. We're gonna teach a lesson here today to you and try to send this to you over Classroom. We'll see how it goes. Obviously, I'm not a professional at this, so kind of bear with me. Feel free to give me some feedback on what you see, what I can do better to help you here. So we're gonna do a lesson today on matrix operations. Started talking about matrix a little bit there last week. Did some solving equations with matrices. So today what I want to talk about is just some basic operations. First thing is we're going to be able to add and subtract matrices, but the key is the matrices have to be the same size. So matrix A is a 2x3 matrix because it's got 2 rows by 3 columns. Matrix B is also a 2x3 matrix because it has 2 rows by 3 columns. And anytime a matrix has the exact same size, you can perform addition and subtraction with that. So we can add matrix A plus B by simply adding the values that are in the same position. So A plus B is going to be 3 plus 1, 0 plus 6, 4 plus 2, negative 2 plus 8, 7 plus 3, and 5 plus negative 1. So once that happens, really what it comes down to is just really being careful of your integer work with your adding and subtracting. So matrix A plus B would add the value of 4, 6, 6, 6, 10, and 4. Okay? So we could also perform subtraction with those same two matrices since they have the same size. So if we wanted to subtract A minus B, again, we're going to take the value that's in the same position, and it's going to be 3 minus 1, 0 minus 6, 4 minus 2, negative 2 minus 8, 7 minus 3, and 5 minus negative 1. And so the value of A minus B would be 2, negative 6, 2, negative 10, 4, and 6. If the matrices do not have the same size, they can't be added and subtracted. Take note also that some of the same properties that apply to just regular addition and subtraction will apply to this also. A plus B is commutative, so it wouldn't matter which way you added them. A minus B is not commutative because B minus A would give you different values when you subtract. Other than that, we can perform the same operations, or the same properties are going to apply to matrix addition and subtraction. Okay? So that's pretty simple. Let me talk about one more thing here today. And that's going to be called scalar multiplication. So scalar multiplication is when I take a number times a matrix. So I'm going to take 4 times A. And everywhere I see, or everywhere there's a value, I'm going to multiply that value times 4. So 4 times 3, 4 times 0, 4 times 4, 4 times negative 2, 4 times 7, and 4 times 5. So 4A would just be matrix A 4 times as big. And we could do things where we take 4, for instance, we could have 4A minus 3B, where in this case, we're gonna have to perform the multiplication first. So 3B will be 3, 18, 6, 24, 9, -3. And then I would subtract those two values. So 12 minus 3 is 9. 0 minus 18 is -18. 16 minus 6 is 10. -8 minus 24 would be -32. 28 minus 9 is 19. 20 minus -3 is 23. And so there would be the value of 4a minus 3b. Okay? So I think what we'll do is I'm going to try to send you something where we can do a little practice of just this. And then I don't know if you have access to a calculator. If not, maybe I can get one sent to you where we can work on matrix multiplication. And we'll try that at a later time. We'll kind of see how this goes. Okay, hopefully everything goes good. And just kind of give me some feedback and let me know. Hopefully everybody's doing well. And thank you very much.